Hi, good evening and welcome to Herder's Global Talk Show. And this evening I have with me one of the best global menswear influencers here with me tonight, Mr. Ecliff Elie.
Hello.
So in case y'all are wondering, which y'all shouldn't be wondering, who Mr. Ecliff Elie is, take a look at some of this footage. Good evening again. So we are going to have a conversation with Mr. Ecliff Elie this evening. So tell me, Mr. Ecliff, tell me about yourself. Let's start there.
Well, me personally, I'm a easygoing person, very hard worker. I like to plan. As you know, I'm a menswear designer. I do that because I love it. Because I enjoy it so much, I don't feel like I work one day in my life.
That's good. So tell me, just briefly, tell me about your childhood. How has your childhood impacted you being a menswear designer?
I like to get involved in fashion, like that. Well, at an early age, my mom, she was a neighborhood seamstress. I came from a huge family. I have a lot of sisters, and they always making dolly clothes and always designing and sewing and so on. So I was someone that, you know, always take pride in the way that I dress from an early, early stage in my life. And I started, you know, helping my mom by the sewing machine and so on. And then when I started secondary school, I chose tailoring in school because I found it was quite easy. But I really wasn't expecting to fall in love with it the way that I did, because it became like really natural, like this was for me. And from there, that was the launch of my career into menswear and fashion.
Okay, so I have a question. Mm-hmm. So you have a mom that was a seamstress, and you have a lot of sisters.
Yeah.
But you're into menswear.
Yeah.
Explain that for me. So.
Well, when I now started, I used to do female wear. I would do swimwear collections. I've put out Miss Universe dresses, Miss World dresses. I've done corporate wear and business wear for companies and so on. When I started, the tailoring and the design comes kind of natural. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to have a company, a business. And the more I study business, I get to realize, when I look at how a business really functions, you have to specialize, like any doctor, everybody specialize.
Right.
It can't be, in menswear, you have a lot of things in menswear. It have sportswear, casual, formal, semi-formal, resort wear. So I decided to focus on resort wear and formal wear for men, and specialize and create a company, and so that I could able, so I was able to, you know, create a business and, you know, really train a team and identify the key product and market it, promote it, sell it, manufacture. So it was a business decision going into menswear. And again, I'm stronger in menswear than female wear because my background is tailoring. So that decision for me was when I made the decision, that was when I decided, okay, time to focus on turning this into a business and not just a hobby.
Okay, understandable. So tell me about your brand. What does your brand stand for?
Well, Ecliff Elie brand stands for elegance, sophistication, success, positive energy. And for me, So let's talk, that is what the Ecliff Elie brand stands for. Mm-hmm. It really gives us self-confidence, because one of the first slogans I used to use when I now started was confidence, comfort, and certainty. Right. And eventually, we keep changing what the brand really stands for. But it's really for comfort, confidence, and certainty.
Okay, understandable. Mm-hmm. So, within recent time, I've seen your brand all the way in Dubai. Right. So, tell me, I know you've been in this for three decades?
Yeah.
What has your journey been like?
Well, it had its hills and valleys. Mm-hmm. I really thank God for the life that I've had, for what He had prepared me for, the challenges, the doors that would have been slammed in your face when you knock. Mm-hmm. Nothing was handed to me easy. So the journey was a very interesting one because when you have a business, you have to get capital. If you talk to any businessman or any creative person, they'll tell you, what are one of the things? Because Trinidad and Tobago are not short of talent, but a lot of people need to get funds to start up their company and their business and to take it in that particular direction. And coming from humble beginnings, I learned how to sacrifice. Right. And being committed and dedicated to to one thing, being loyal to what it is. I treated my career with respect, and in return, my career have really respected me and carried me a lot of places.
Okay, understandable. So I know you don't only do suits. A lot of your suits have been trending. I've seen lyrical, I've seen blacks, I've seen your suits all over.
Yeah.
But you have other, you have accessories and other things.
Yeah.
Tell us more about that.
Well, I just didn't want it to be another, fashion merchandiser. Mm-hmm. Where you go to Atlanta or Miami or Curacao or Panama and just buy products and bring it and sell it. For me, it's not about that. It's about building a brand, a respected brand. And I realized how important that brand is mm-hmm. when I started making bootleg t-shirts. Mm-hmm. I would sit down, sew about at least 1,000 t-shirts, and I'll put a Nike Tech on it, or a Nike Tech, or a Jordan, or Reebok, and Adidas, and I realized how people wasn't interested in wearing clothing. They were interested in wearing a brand, whether if it's Levi's and so on. It has always been like that. Mm-hmm. So what I did, I didn't really like my full name, Ecliff Elie, because I used to be heckled a lot in school.
Right.
And so then I said, you know what? I made a decision again. I'm not going to make any bootleg clothes. I'm not going to go house to house selling, sell on the side of the road anymore. I'm not going to sell in any flea market. And so I designed my own shoes. So we have the Ecliff, so I understand branding. So at this point, I stopped selling clothing and I'm selling a brand. Because I know once you build a brand, it will be respected and people buy your brand. So right now, people just don't say they want a suit. They say they want an Ecliff Elie suit.
Yes.
They want an Ecliff Elie shirt, an Ecliff Elie pants, an Ecliff Elie trousers. Mm-hmm. So the hard work and the sacrifice I'd made in terms of building a brand. I remember one time, a very good friend of mine, at one time he was a director at my company as well. And he said, I just came from a store on the road, I wouldn't call it a store. But I'm seeing two khaki pants. We could get two khaki pants for $100. What by you is $3.95. I didn't know what to tell him. Mm-hmm. So I said, yeah, but it's not an Ecliff Elie. And that was many years when I had my tailor shop. It just flashed back at me. I talking about the size of my business or the size of a bedroom, a 10 by 10.
Right.
I said, yeah, but it's $2,400. And if I buy a shirt, I get a tie. But if I come by you, I say, yeah, you will get that. But it's not an Ecliff Elie. And so I just didn't know what to tell him, and I just keep on saying everything he said. I said, but it's not an Ecliff Elie. So,
right.
And the brand wasn't nowhere close to where it is now, but I've always believed in what I do and gave the work that I put out 150% and respected all my work, and eventually my customers and everybody else started to respect the brand.
Okay. Well, from what you said, as emerging somebody, building an emerging enterprise, that's definitely something that I think is a good takeaway.
Yeah.
To believe in your brand, in your business, whatever you're you're dabbling into, you know. So I definitely gonna take note of that. Right. When did you realize, you know, the potential of your brand? Because I mean, you're not just in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah.
You're all over. When did you realize, how, at what point you realize how far your brand was?
When I started having prime ministers of different countries contacting me to do stuff for them, and the first ladies,
mm-hmm.
well, they apparently just them sometimes, and you know, okay. they started contacting me and government. Just recently, we did a tourism minister from another island, and mm-hmm. when yeah, one of those different, and when we land at the airport, they send in drivers, and that's why some kind of star, you know.
Right.
So that's when you realize. But you know, when you're in a workshop working, you don't really study that at all.
That's true.
Because we are not on the outside looking in. We are in the kitchen. We cooking, you know. Mm-hmm. We sewing. We working hard. We're not doing it for fame, you know. But you know that does come. That has come over time, but I prefer work in the sewing room with the stitchers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I really enjoy meeting customers. I love the customer service of the business, and I love working with the stitchers. But I like to, you know, get my hands dirty, so that really keep you grounded.
All right. I know you said, you know, initially you were okay. So we have a caller, so I'm gonna take this call. Right. Hi. Good evening, caller.
What am I doing? Dissatisfied with one of Mr. Ecliff Elie's his product.
If you're dissatisfied?
Hi, can you take one off?
Okay, so could you just turn down
yeah,
the volume?
You need to lower
your
volume.
Television a little bit for us, please, because we're getting the feedback.
I'm going to
hang up, but
yeah, shall cover. Okay, so she said if it is satisfied,
mm-hmm.
right? No, that's fine. That's good. Because at Ecliff Elie, right?
Mm-hmm.
One of the things we do is give a lifetime warranty on all our garments. And that is how much we want people to know we have your back, right?
Mm-hmm.
And with the lifetime warranty, what that does is if you gain weight or lose weight, we'll do adjustments for you. If you don't like what the garment fit, bring it back. The door is always open. As a matter of fact, I make myself available
mm-hmm.
with any customer or anyone who has any issue with anything.
Mm-hmm.
So like, for example, one of the things, when I started our tailor shop, one of the things people always used to say is, but how come my garment is not fitting correctly, right? And I'll say, well, and it took measurements. I will say, okay, well, once we are doing a fitting, we'll always find ways to critique the look and find ways to enhance it.
Right.
So expect, I'm letting you know one time, when you come, because even our fitting forms have up to three fittings. So if you don't fit good the first time, you fit the second time, and then you could fit the third time. However, if you leave and you go on 5 years on, you'll gain weight or lose weight, bring it back. We'll adjust it for you.
That's definitely something you would want from a brand. I mean, when do you intend to get women under this umbrella again?
Well, very soon we'll be start back. Very soon we'll start back designing and outfitting women. But we'll be focusing on constructed clothing, like well-tailored mm-hmm. suits, well-tailored dresses, well-tailored shirts, you know, to give you a really neat, nice corporate look.
Okay, all right. Yeah. So we are going to take a break and we'll be back after this. Hi, good evening. We are back and we are here with Mr. Ecliff Elie.
Yes.
Right, so he was actually just getting into some very interesting information, letting us know for the ladies, Ecliff Elie is about to get us under his umbrella, waiting patiently.
Yes.
Right, so tell us some more about that now.
Okay, so as I said, very soon we'll be starting, we will be constructing women wear.
Mm-hmm.
Which is constructed clothing,
mm-hmm.
Tailoring like his business suits and business dress, well, tailored dresses, tailored shirt, tailored trousers, tailored jackets for women very soon.
Okay, so I mean, you mentioned in conversation that you like to be involved.
Yes.
Now you have prime ministers and everybody calling you for suits.
Yeah.
How do you balance your family life and business?
Well, you have to make time for your family, so you have to plan your time. Also, I understand that you want to take a call.
Okay, give me 1 minute, let me just take this caller. Hi, good evening, caller.
Good afternoon, my dear.
Hi, good evening.
And good afternoon to the man himself.
Yes, good evening.
Mr. Dapper. Yes. Mr. Elie.
Yes.
Now, I know of all the outfits and things. If I had married again, I sure commend by you. I just want to find out one thing.
Sure.
You're going into the eyewear too?
The eyewear?
The eyewear.
Well,
because I mean, I see you looking, the one that you have on there.
Yeah. Yes, eyewear is one of the things we'll become a line of eyewear, cologne. We already have shoes, belts, bags, a line of bags.
Nice, so, yeah. I like that. So when you see a come, total transformation.
Yes, brother. And what we do too is image consultation, where we help you put your wardrobe in perspective. So it's a simple conversation based on your lifestyle, and we can help you, you know, really enhance your image, because we believe in consistency. It'll make sense to come and buy me to make a suit look really, really good today, and then tomorrow you're going back wearing the normal stuff, unless it's for occasion. So if you really want to enhance your wardrobe and your look, you know, it's something that we really enjoy doing, transforming people.
And so you say you're going into, you have cologne and all of that, right?
No, very eyewear and cologne, all those things are scheduled to
Beautiful. Because listen, it has some fellas like old Vauxhall, you know. If you could bring back an old Vauxhall, you're real good, you know.
Now, well, we don't do straightening and painting.
I know you don't do straightening and painting.
Yeah, we don't deal with filler and arm
thing. Nah, but well, I think I know where the place is,
yes.
And you will be seeing the eye sooner than you think.
Yes, brother. Thanks to the caller. I really appreciate it. And thank you very much.
Nice. Beautiful.
Thank you, caller.
Yeah. So, what was the question?
Okay. So, you were telling me about how do you balance, you know,
right.
Family
so
life.
So, you have to, old school. You have to make a list, manage your time. What I realize is, you know, I think about the future a lot, you know, and I think about the legacy that I'm building, and how, in the event something happened to me, what will happen to my business?
Mm-hmm.
And something happened to me, it don't have to be something negative, it could be something positive.
Right.
I got an opportunity, we have to travel for 6 months, 3 months. So let's look at the positive, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what happens to my company, what happens to my business?
Mm-hmm.
So I started doing business management and so on, and trying to figure ways that my business could run without me. And I also realized the more your business could run without you, the more valuable it becomes. Because in business, sometimes you tell yourself you have a business, but if you don't work, you will not get paid. And what you did was create a job for yourself. And if I don't turn up to work, none of my staff will get paid, right?
Right.
So I have, write down the things that I want to achieve, how I want the business to function. And then I had to start to create departments like HR, accounting, marketing, the operations, production, the courier. So all I do really is just sign checks, right? My check to the secret, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? And so I create a system of reporting. So I meet with different, I have a lot of meeting with the staff because I want to know what's going on. Yeah. I really, really, really want to know. So I'm very much involved in the business, but I also know the more your business runs out you, the more valuable it is.
Okay.
It becomes. So with that now, I'll be able to free up time to spend time with family and really focus on being creative. But it's very hard to be a creative person and run a business at the same time.
That is true. So based on what you're saying, you seem to have a system. Well, not seem to. You do have a system in place, right?
Yes.
Was it always like this? Or what was your mental state of mind from then to now? Mm-hmm. You know, because especially as a business, grooming a business, nurturing a business, you go through these different phases.
Right.
So, I mean, now you seem to have it all together. But mentally, what were some of the hurdles that you would have encountered in trying to get your business to where it is now?
Well, I mean, hurdles is the name of the game. So somebody like me who had no academic background, at age 14, I thought I couldn't learn. Mm-hmm. You know, so because I had a horrible experience going to Creob Junior Secondary School with some of my teachers, based on some of the challenges I've had, I would have had to reach the school, just to reach the school.
Right.
So, like, okay, so I'm a good listener, you know, I take advice.
1 second. Hi, good evening, caller.
Good evening. I just want to ask this guy a question. Eli? Eli.
Yes.
Hey, good evening. I am calling from Grenada.
Yes.
Hi, good evening. We're hearing you.
Yeah, I'm calling from Grenada. How could I get in touch with this guy to get, and how would he supply suits, does he supply suits to Grenada?
Yes, yeah, I do. I have a clientele in Grenada. As a matter of fact, I spoke to one of my customers from Grenada today. Also, the reigning soca monarch, I outfit him, Vaughn, and a few other artists from Grenada. I've been Grenada often. I also advertise when I'm coming to Grenada because I meet at the Radisson Hotel, at the conference room where I meet people and I come back and fit them. And there's a really good tailor in Grenada. He's up the hill. I think his name is David. Up the hill in Grenada. I did a story on him and there's a video I play all the time. So I have videos where I came to Grenada because I travel with a production crew and I produce some videos in Grenada as well. Yeah, so I speak Grenada often. So I can be reached on 62.
Your tailor is the right in St. George's?
Yes, I think it's David is the guy name. Yeah, the tailor. Okay. So I can be he listening to television. So I can be reached on Instagram, Ecliff Elie, or Facebook, Ecliff Elie. I can inbox me. Respond to all my messages. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you could probably say that over, just in case, because I realized the caller was actually listening on the television.
So I can be reached on Instagram, all right, at Ecliff Elie, or Facebook, Ecliff Elie Limited, and I respond to all my messages. So if once you send me a message, I guarantee me I'll respond.
Yes, and we could guarantee you have a great soup.
Yeah.
Right? All right. So we were speaking about your mentally, you know, from where you were to now.
Well, I mean, I learn my mistakes, right? And as I said, I become a very good listener. I always value what it is I do because I always strive for excellence and trying to give good customer service and as well as create a good garment because a really good product because I know once you're in the line of business that I'm in, it's 3 things to take into consideration, which is the cost, right? The quality and the time, because one always affects the other. So when I have my tailor shop, I would go to Port of Spain, buy fabric, come back to Arima, and as a black entrepreneur, it's real challenging, you know, because you hear the talk, I mean, sometimes in a tailor shop and somebody, you run late, I don't know, way back in the day, and they'll say, that's why black people can never have a business, that's why black people never reach no way, because, I mean, Unfortunately, we didn't come from family with people who had businesses. It have nobody in my family I know have a business, right? Mm-hmm. And I could have learned from. So I learned from my mistakes. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I really like people talk down at me and, you know, once you show down a challenge, I'll try to beat it, to win. So I remember like going to I'll change like $5 in coins, go to the coin phone, schedule all my appointments by the coin phone. And then eventually I realized I'm doing everything. So what I started doing, I started to scale my business. And only now that I understand business, I realized I was scaling. So I would make a list of things that I have to do, figure out the things that I have and must do. And so I'd say, okay, I need to bring in someone to just answer calls, to deal with customers, so I could focus on my craft. Then I realized, okay, the straight stitches, I could have somebody just do a common straight stitch. Then I could focus on the technical stitches, like making the back pocket, front pocket, mm-hmm. The chest plate on a jacket and so on. So I was actually scaling my business. Then I realized I grew all the spots I was in. I'm making some bad mistakes. I realized, okay, I need to market. So I used to like walk all over, remind flyers, just promoting my business. So, mm-hmm. you know, so by doing everything myself, I realized, well, wait. So I reached a point now where I only hire experts. So even though I don't have a degree, a master's degree in anything, I'd have people, a lot of my team have their master's degree and so on working for me now, because, and some of them, whenever I speak with them, they just be like, well, Mr. Eli, this is what they taught us in school. How come you know that? You know, mm-hmm. and most of the things I learned is from my mistakes, mm-hmm. you know, but, you know, the good thing about now, you have places you could go and learn how to do.
I have a question. Yeah. So like you rightfully said, because this is not just your story. I think a lot of people looking on can probably relate, like they are probably the first person in their family, in their household to start a business or want to push themselves in a business, right? But at some point in time, you need somebody, a mentor, yeah. to say. Mm-hmm. Did you have a mentor, and yeah. at what point did you realize, listen, I need a mentor?
Well, you see, people tend to see your full potential. Sometimes they do really see yourself. People see it, look at you. Because I remember at age 17, after I graduated from school, I went looking for a job at KFC. I didn't get through. A security guard, Pizza Hut, I didn't get through. And my last $5, I used my last $5, and I traveled back to school in September to see my tailoring teacher. And he was just like real upset, you know. He was like, listen, use my number one tailor, so I'm looking to be a security guard. And I still didn't know what to do. So it was a neighbor carrying me, trying to get a job for me at a garment factory, and I was too slow. Mm-hmm. Because my craft is tailoring, is like art. And I tried to get a job in the mass production field, I still didn't get a job. Mm-hmm. I didn't own a sewing machine, and a tailor gave me a break, Tony Isaac, up in Mount Pleasant in Arima. Tony Isaac gave me a break, and the break was, I have a machine in the corner there doing nothing, you could go and use it if you just get orders. Mm-hmm. And that was my break. And then at 17, 18 year old, Tony seen how dedicated I was, and you know, he would talk to me and encourage me, and eventually started to move like a father. He was like, no, you can't do this, you can't do that, make sure and leave here, come back a certain time, you know. Mm-hmm. And you know, and then, you know, so people just saw something in me that I wasn't really seeing. You know, so along the way, and then I meet like Ted Bruce, where I started making puppet clothing, and you know, I used to talk to me about, you know, Ecliff, don't be a hustler, you know, don't everything is not about money, you know, and you know, so it have a lot of people along the way, and then like from reading books associating yourself with good friends, you know, choosing your friends, and you know, so along the way, there are a lot of people who have spoken to me, and I took advice, and you know, I just utilized it and so on.
That is very important, though. Friends, you know, when you start to get productive, for some strange reason, yeah. right, you end up isolated.
Yeah.
Because to me, this is me personally, and I have, you know, based on conversations that I have had with my peers, with, you know, people within my circle,
yeah.
once you get focus, you yeah. become, it's like you walking on a road, on a
yeah.
lonely road,
yeah, yeah,
right? So at this point, and then, I mean, yeah. at this point, I think you really start to evaluate, you know, people in your life, and I mean,
yeah.
I mean, people will be like, he feel he there, she feel she there, yeah. you know how it's go,
yeah.
right? But at that point, What was your mental at that point, emotionally?
Well, I couldn't, when everybody was partying and having a good time going to the club and all that, I used to be sewing the clothing. I couldn't go on party, I couldn't go to the club, I couldn't go to no bazaar because I'm making everybody jeans, everybody shirt, whatever it is. I used to be working and then in order for me not to be unreliable, I had to be committed, because then sometimes I take a deposit on somebody pants or whatever and you have to just stay there and do it. You know?
So
everybody who was around my age, they used to be going out and partying. I used to be working. I used to be building my empire. So now I could relax and travel the world.
Yes. Yeah. Alright, so you are hearing it right here this evening on Gaia from Mr. Ecliff Elie himself, but we're going to take a break and we'll be back shortly.
Ecliff Elie presents
So we are back and we are here this evening in studio with Mr. Ecliff Elie.
Yes.
Right. So we were just talking about friends and, you know, when you get all focused, how it becomes a lonely road.
Yes.
Right. So in a situation like this, right, I mean, emotionally, how did you deal with this? I mean, yes, you were, you know, basically starting your business, so your focus was your business, but you know, there are these periods where you sort of get depressed. It's like, I don't really have nobody. It, like, you know, at that point in time, you know, you actually start thinking about all these different ideas. It's like, especially when you're just getting started, to me, your mind is just be running wild. Like, you have all these grand ideas, and majority of the time, one of the biggest mistakes is not being focused on one. Like, okay, for instance, you, let's just say in your situation, you're sewing clothes, and then somebody, you might get your next idea, hey, I better go and, you know, start a brand clothes here. Hey, let me buy jewelry from there and start to sell jewelry here. And it started to be all over the place. Yeah. How did you keep yourself together, focused, and know that, listen, all right, this is where I am?
Yeah.
And this is where I am going.
Well, first, you know, they say love what you do and you'll never work a day in your life. That is what I live by. That is what I stand by. I'm not someone to be like all over. You know, I like to focus on my strengths, things that I'm good at. When I used to do female wear and swimwear, that was the fun part of it. That was just the hobby and the fun part where you get kind of bored. But I still stay within my early time for going through that. You know, the words that Theophilus Furlong spoke to me, which was my tailoring teacher. You know, that one tongue lashing at age 17, that was it for me. I didn't need anybody to tell me. He told me I need to stay focused. You cannot be no security guard. You cannot work in no KFC. You need to stay focused. All right, and then what I was doing, I was good at it, and it was generating revenue. It was generating cash for me. So I was able to save. I was able to, you know, so I realized, well, okay, this is what I need to stick with, and then it was effortless. And for me, what was more important than getting paid for it was making people happy, you know, seeing, and then guys my age, as I said, older folk, they will come and they will. I remember one time, this guy was older than me, right? Mm-hmm. And his mother gave him money for lessons, right? He took his money for lessons mm-hmm. and came by me and make her jeans, right? But the woman, she came, she called me on the phone. I was like, God rest his soul, he passed away. His name was Kenny. Kenny, mother called me on the phone and blew me out on the phone, real blow. How you could take money from a little boy? How you could do that? He's a wicked man, I think. So Kenny mother came at my gate. Right, but I home, you know, I young, I still a teenager. So I came outside bareback and in a short pants. Yeah, so Kenny mother's like, good day, I'm your father home. I said, no, what's up? Yeah, she was like, this tailor, real wicked, take my son money to make her pants. I said, is I you? And I think Kenny big and stronger than me. I invited the lady inside and she was so amazed. She was like, wait now, you make all them things, you know? How old are you? And then she switched out. If Kenny was only smart like you, he would not be taking the lessons money to come and make clothes. And she eventually became a customer because I was sewing for women at that time. Mm-hmm. And then when she saw the trousers I created for Kenny, which was a jeans, mm-hmm. you know, she started to actually give Kenny money to come by me, you know. So that's a flashback. I just remember that, you know.
That's nice.
So. Yeah, so that's another story.
Appreciate it. So tell me something. In terms of, I mean, you very much have things together. So I'm sure you would have had goals for your business.
Yeah.
Right? I want to know, what is your vision for Ecliff Elie? I mean, I know you're far from finished.
Yeah.
But what is your vision? And as well, what are some of the milestones? What are some of the accomplishments, some of the milestones that you have already, you know, hit?
Wow. Okay. Well, in terms of the milestones.
Okay, just one second, yeah. Right? Hi. Good evening, caller.
Hello.
Hi. Good evening. Okay. I'm sorry, caller. I'll have to hang up. I'm not hearing you.
Hello.
Hi. Good evening.
I'm calling the TV station. I don't know if I'm disconnected to something else.
No, you are live at on Hurdles.
Yes.
So I'm pretty sure that you are live at on
Hurdles. What I want, I'm listening to Mr. Ike for this hour. I'm a 75-year-old woman.
Mm-hmm.
And I am speaking about making clothing. And I'm wondering if you make clothing for grown-ups like me.
Okay, I'm sure he's going to take that question.
Yes, I make clothing for grown-ups, of course. At the moment, we focus mainly on menswear.
Okay, caller. So, Mr. Ecliff Elie indicated that yes, he does make clothing for grown-ups. At this point in time, he focuses on menswear. Right?
Yes, so what's the question?
Yes, so I was asking you, I know you would have had goals that yes. you would have set out. Mm-hmm. What are some of the accomplishments that you've had for your brand this far?
It depends on what. Well, you see, when I set a high standard for yourself, you never feel you really achieve or accomplish what you really want to accomplish. But some of the things we have done over the years, well, at the moment, we have like three locations. Mm-hmm. One at C3 Shopping Center in San Fernando, one at West Mall, our most recent store, and also our store at Rosalino Street, Woodbrook. We also have an e-commerce website where you could purchase stuff and deliver within 24 hours. So that for me, that is a huge accomplishment. And then we have our workshop, our atelier, where we produce the garments. One of my biggest accomplishments, one of them, I think, is being able to hire staff and give them that security when it comes to a job, and you know.
Give me one second, right? Hi, good evening, caller.
Yes, good afternoon. Me again, Mr. Ecliff.
Yes, brother.
Yes, brother, I'm watching you. You seem to have things down pat, boy. Because I'm listening to you. Because I myself have a couple. I dabble in this thing already, in business already, so I know. Right. And listening to you, you have it right. Because one of the two ways I know you could make money is either you work for money or your money work for you.
Right.
And right now, your money working for you. And from listening to you, and the answers you give, it tells me that you did a SWOT analysis in your business.
Yes. Yes, certainly.
That's correct. So you know your strength, your weakness, your opportunities, and your threats.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. I will really have, anyhow, I will get personal contact.
Yes.
Because I need to discuss something with you offline.
Yes. Certainly, yeah. Yeah, you can arrange that.
Nice. Cool.
Okay, brother. Thanks. Appreciate the call.
Thank you, caller.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so I really enjoy doing business, right? And I really like employing people and training. I really like training staff and making sure I give them all the tools that they need to carry the duty. So like tomorrow we have a training session with the staff, with all the stylists. So we open tomorrow from 2 o'clock. At all the locations, because we have in a stylist workshop. So it's with me, HR, IT. I use a lot of software as well. So for me, one of the major accomplishments is that team oriented and building a brand. And you know, I want all the team members to be experts at fashion. So I really like to share knowledge. And one of my major, well, one of them is really helping people, seeing them grow, giving them a job and the proper tools to really grow in a personal life as well as a professional life, because what we do when we train is like team building and also to really enhance your self-confidence. And you know, you have to be self-confident before you sell anybody anything or to tell somebody, this is you right here, this perfect, this is you, this is the correct silhouette for you, this is the cut you want, this is the color for your skin tone. And for that, if you're not sure, the person really believe you, they will not believe you. So we don't believe in like selling customers dreams and lying to them, and we don't do that at all. You know, we do encourage that, we don't do that. So we really want the team members, if something not looking good, tell the customer, listen, that not looking good.
Uh-huh.
You know, so for me, one of the major accomplishments is really helping people to be experts at what they do in my field.
Okay. You mentioned just now about training, right?
Yes.
I mean, at this point, I honestly see you as a guru, right? You are like one of the best men's wear influencers. So do you have any intentions of like, you know, having any workshops? Probably not you personally, but Ecliff Elie, the brand. Do you all intend to like nurture upcoming tailors or fashion designers under your umbrella?
Yeah. Well, I mean, if I commit to do that, I'll have to do it, because a man's word is his honor. So if I say I'll do it, I'll have to do it. I don't have the time to hold someone's hand and carry them to the next step, to the next step, to the next step. However, I like to speak positivity into people's lives. So I get invited to speak at graduations. I have a seminar coming up where I've been invited to speak. So I'm getting paid for speaking gigs now. It was not my, you know, so it have like, I think about 90 guests will be attending. The name of it is Amplify. And just imagine, I talking to people how to scale a business, you know, so, because they want to know how I scale mines.
Right.
And then I'll get some
example.
Yeah. So, you know, so like that, you know, I touch people's lives, and at the end, they'll bounce up someone and say, you know what, I was doing this all the time, but because you said, make sure and be committed to what you're doing, and that I was able to really find, you know, fall in love with that, fall in love with something, and then turn it into a career and give it the respect to turn it into a business. So people, you know, will meet me and tell me stuff like that, you know.
So tonight we were live with Mr. Ecliff Elie, one of the best menswear influencers, I would say globally now, because he's no longer just talking TNT. He is all over, right? I saw his suits being showcased all the way in Dubai just up to this week going here. So Mr. Ecliff Elie is really up there, right? So I will just ask you to take this time to give out your social media handles, your contact information, so that people will definitely be able to get in contact with you.
All right, well, once you can spell the name correctly, Ecliff Elie, I'm the only person with that name. So I can be reached on social media. If you Google the name, all my information will come up. You can, if you want to reach out to me, you can call 624-2773 and I'll definitely get back to you. If you send me a message on social media, I'll definitely respond. I respond to all my messages. So I'm on Instagram and Facebook. And yeah, that's it.
All right. So thank you very much for joining us here this evening on Hurdles Global Talk Show. Thank you very much to Gaia Caribbean for accepting me as part of the team. Thank you very much to Taylor That Braid for my hairstyle. Thank you very much to Russia Parallel TT. And we will be here next week again at 9 p.m. with another guest. But for now, we'd like to thank you from the Gaia family. Thank you very much, Mr. Ecliff Elie, for joining us this evening and sharing such wonderful, heartfelt stories that are going to touch, inspire, motivate, and definitely force our viewers to take actions from today.
Yes.
Right?
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Have a good evening, everyone.